channel Netphysics, and if you're watching this video for the very first time, then I would request you to please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, do not forget to hit the bell icon. So in this video we shall discuss the questions of CSIR and NET examinations, and this paper is of December 2014 and all the questions are from electromagnetic. So, here the first question is that we have a charged particle and it is moving in a helical path under the influence of a constant magnetic field. Also, it is given the initial velocity. It is such that the component along the magnetic field, it is twice the component in the plane normal to the magnetic field. And we have to find the ratio of the pitch L to the radius R of the helical path. So we are having here four options. So in the question, it is given the pitch is L, okay, of the helical path, and the radius is R. A charged particle is moving in helical path under the influence of constant magnetic field. So for velocity, we will consider V parallel and V perpendicular. These are the velocity component along the magnetic field and perpendicular to the magnetic field. Perpendicular to the magnetic field means the component in the plane normal to the magnetic field. So according to the question, we will have that V parallel is equals to 2V perpendicular. This is the condition given in the question. And we have to find the ratio L by R, right? So for this, we will use the formula of time period, because we know that the pitch of the helix L, it is equals to V parallel into it T. So we will write the value of the time period of revolution in the circular orbit, which is 2 pi R by V perpendicular. So we will substitute here the value of T, okay, from this formula. And we will see, if we take this R to the left hand side, we will get our required ratio. So L is equals to V parallel 2 pi R V perpendicular. And we will put here V parallel was equals to what? 2 V perpendicular, which we will substitute here. And we will see this V perpendicular and this V perpendicular will get cancelled. And finally, bringing this R to the left hand side, we will get the ratio of the pitch L to the radius R of the helical path equals to 2 to the 4 pi. So the correct option is option B. So this question is just based on formula. We don't have to go for like a very complicated concept. The only thing is about formula. So now let's come to the next question. Here the next question is, a parallel beam of light of wavelength lambda, it is incident normally on a thin polymer film with air on both the sides. If the film has a refractive index n which is greater than 1, then the second order bright fringes can be observed in reflection when the thickness of the film is. So here it is given a parallel beam of light is there whose wavelength is lambda and it is incident normally on a thin polymer and polymer film and which is having air on both the sides. Now if the film, it is having a refractive index n and that particular refractive index is greater than 1, then second order bright fringes, we can observe this second order bright fringes in a reflection when the thickness will be how much? We have to find the thickness of the film, okay, at which we can see or we can observe the second order bright fringes. If the refractive index of the film, it is greater than 1, right? So for this, if we want to see bright fringes, that is for constructive interference, we will see the formula for constructive interference, right? So for constructive interference, we have 2nd cos theta, it is equals to 2m plus 1 lambda by 2. For normal incidence, we know that theta will be equal to 0 degree and second order means m is equals to 1. This is just very basic. I am not going into it. We know for normal incidence, theta is equals to 0 and for second order, m will be equals to 1. So if we put the value of theta to be 0 and m equals to 1, we will get the thickness of the film. So 2nd cos 0, it is equals to 2 into with 1, which is taken m is equals to 1 plus 1 lambda by 2. So cos 0 is equals to 1. So we will have only 2 and d on the left hand side, and in the right hand side we will have 3 lambda by 2. This is 2 ones are 2 plus 1. So 3 lambda by 2. And finally we will have d is equals to 3 lambda by 4n. So this is the correct option. The correct option is option D. Means when D, the thickness of the film will be 3 lambda by 4n, it's then when we can see the second order bright fringes. Okay, and the refractive index is greater than 1 in this case. So now let's come to the next question. So in this question we have a solid sphere whose radius is r and it is having charge density. Okay, rho r is equals to rho naught 1 minus alpha, ar by r. R it is the radial component, rho naught a and capital R, these are the positive constants. And the magnitude of the electric field at this r equals to radial coordinate is equals to r by 2. It is equals to 1 by 2.5 times of the electric field which is at r equals to capital R. And we have to find the value of small a. So here we are having four options. So firstly, the given quantity is the charge density. So we will write charge density is equals to rho naught 1 minus ar by r. So using the Gauss integral formula, we know that close integral of E dot dA, it is equals to what? Q enclosed by epsilon naught, which is equals to Q enclosed is equals to what? Integration of rho d tau, right? Because this is a solid sphere. Now what we will do, we will integrate, the left hand side will be the magnitude of E into with 4 pi r square. E dot dA, dA is 4 pi r square because this is a solid sphere. And it is equals to 1 by epsilon naught integrating r from 0 to r, theta from 0 to pi and phi from 0 to 2 pi. Now we will put the value of rho. Rho is equals to rho naught 1 minus ar by capital R. And d tau is equals to what? R square sine theta dr d theta d phi. Right. In the left hand side and in the right hand side, 4 pi will get cancelled. And this 4 pi is from what? We know sine theta d theta d phi. It will be 4 pi. And we have to just integrate r. Now 0 to r, r square. Rho naught is a constant which is outside. This will give you r square minus a r cube by capital R dr. Now we will have in the left hand side E, the magnitude of electric field into with r square equals to rho naught by epsilon naught. And now integrating this term, we will have what? R to the power 3 by 3 minus a by r is a constant, r to the power 4 by 4. And since the limit was 0 to 4, so we will get the same quantity. R to the power 3 here, r to the power 4 here. Now we can see if we take r square common from this term, we will cancel the left hand side and right hand side. Okay, r square will get cancelled from both the left hand side and the right hand side. And finally, we will have the electric field E is equals to rho naught by epsilon naught. And here we will have r by 3 since 1 r square is outside minus a r square by 4 r since 1 r square is outside. Now finally, we will get the magnitude of electric field to be rho naught by epsilon naught equals to into r by 3 minus a r square by 4 r. So this is the magnitude of electric field. Okay, now we will use the condition. It was given that the magnitude of electric field at r is equals to r by 2, it is equals to what? 1.25 times of the electric field at r is equals to capital R. So we will substitute in this equation r equals to r by 2 in the left hand side, and in the right hand side we will use r is equals to capital R. So here if you see, this is rho naught by epsilon naught, this I am taking capital R by 2 minus a by 4 r, this is again capital R by 2 whole square, 1.25 it will be as it is. And here we will have rho naught by epsilon naught, this is r by 3 because this is for r is equals to capital R, minus a r square by 4 r. Now this rho naught epsilon naught from the left hand side and right hand side both will get cancelled. And you will here have here what? R by 6 minus, this is a r square, 4 4s are 16 r, right? This was r square by r. So 1 r it is getting cancelled. Now equals to 1.25 is as it is. This term got cancelled. Here you will have r by 3 minus this r and this r gets cancelled and you are having a r by 4. Now what you will see in this term, you will have r by 6 minus a r by 16 equals to 5 by 4. I have written 1.25 as 5 by 4 into with r by 3 minus ar by 4. This you can do on your own. Now r by 6 minus ar by 16, it is equals to what? Multiplying 5 by 4 with this complete term, we will have 5 r by 12 minus 5 ar by 16, right? Now we will take the like terms on one side and other like terms to the other side. So I am taking 5ar by 16, this term to the left hand side, this term I have brought to the left hand side since it is negative, and this is minus ar by 16. Again this 5r by 12, bringing this r by 6 to the right hand side. Now we will do the subtractions or addition, whatever it is. So taking in these two terms, if you see here, this is 16, okay, 16 minus, sorry, 5ar by 16 minus ar by 16, right? If I take LCM 16, we will have a what? 5ar minus ar equals to 12 and 6, the LCM will be 12. So we will have what? 5r minus 2r. Now finally, this will give us what? 4ar by 16, because 5 minus 1 is 4 and ar is as it is. This is giving us 3r. In the denominator, it is 16 and 12. Now we have to find the value of a. So a is equals to what? This term will come into the right hand side. So it will be 16 by 4r into with 3r by 12. So if you see, this r will get cancelled with this r. Okay. So this is this. This will cancel with this. 4 4s are 16. Again, 4 3s are 12. Again, this 3 and this 3 will cancel. Finally, you can cancel on your own, because it may. I can show you here also if you want. See, this is simple, but still I am showing you. 16 by 4r into with 3r by 12. This is how it is. So this is 3 4s are, right? This is 4 4s are. This 4 will get cancelled with this 4. This r will get cancelled with r. This is how it is. And you will get a is equals to 1. So the correct option is option B. Now let's come to the next question. Here what we are having, the electrostatic lines of force due to a system of 4 point charges. It is sketched below. This is the sketch where we are having electrostatic lines of force due to 4 point charges. And we have to see at a large distance r, the leading asymptotic behavior of the electrostatic potential is proportional to. Means we have to see the proportionality of the electrostatic potential. Okay. With respect to r. So since these electrostatic lines of force, these are due to quadrupole, right? And in case of quadrupole, we know that the electrostatic potential V, it is proportional to 1 by R cube. So finally, we will have V is proportional to R to the power minus 3. So the correct option is option D. If you have any doubt, then you can check out my video of multiple expansion. If you want, I can mention, I will mention the link in the description box. You can check out the video. Now let's come to the next question. So here we are having a plane electromagnetic wave which is incident normally on the surface of a material and it is reflected back partially, and the measurement on the standing wave in the region in front of the interference will show that the ratio of the electric field at the maxima and minima is 5, and we have to find the ratio of the reflected intensity to that of the incident intensity. So here we are considering A and B, these are the amplitude of the incident wave. And in the question, we have the electric field at the maxima and the minima, that is A plus B by A minus B is equals to 5. This is what it is given in the question. Now we know that I maximum, okay, the maximum intensity by minimum intensity is equals to what? A plus B by A minus B whole square, which means it is equals to what? 5 square, right? This is the formula. Now from this two, if we will equate the power, we will have A plus B is equals to what? 5A minus 5E, doing the cross multiplication in the same step. Again, bringing this 5A, bringing this A to the right hand side and bringing this 5B to the other side, we will have what? 5A minus A is equals to what? 4A, and 5B plus B is equals to 6B. And this will give us A by B is equals to 3 by 2. Right. Now we have to find the ratio of the reflected intensity to the incident intensity. We are having the amplitude of the incident wave A by B, the ratio to be 3 by 2. Now the ratio of intensity reflected and incident, okay, it will be how much? Reflected intensity by incident intensity, which will be equals to what? B by A, okay, which is equals to what? A by B was equals to 3 by 2. So B by A will be equals to what? 2 by 3 whole square. So finally we will have 4 by 9, right? That is the ratio of the intensity reflected to the intensity incident. It is 4 by 9. So the correct option is option A. Now let's come to the last question of this mass is M, charge is E, and it is moving with a velocity V and acceleration A. And this particle, it is emitting radiations of intensity I. We have to find out the intensity of emitted radiation. If the mass of the particle is M by 2, charge is 2IC, velocity is V by 2, and acceleration is 2A. So here we are having four options. Okay. We know that the intensity of radiation emitted by an accelerated particle is proportional to the square of the charge into with the square of the acceleration. Right. So here we will consider I1 to be the intensity for the first case and I2 to be the intensity for the second case. So I1 by I2, it is equal to what? Q1 square, A1 square by Q2 square, A2 square. So in the first case, the charge was E and the acceleration was A. And in the second case, the charge was 2IC and the acceleration was 2IC. So it is 2E whole square into 2A whole square. So on simplifying, we will have E square into with A square divided by 4E square into with 4A square. E square, E square and A square, S square will get cancelled from the numerator and the denominator. And finally, we will have I1 by I2 is equals to 1 by 16. And it will give us the intensity of the emitted radiation. For the second case, it is equals to what? 16? I. Okay, so the correct option is option A. So that's all in this video. If you like my video, then I would request you to share with your friends, and also if you have any queries, any suggestions, then you can comment me in the comment section. Also, do not forget to hit the bell icon, subscribe, like, comment. Thank you so much. Have a good day.